guys, welcome to my third class of inverse Laplace transform. In the first class, I discussed how to convert Laplace to inverse Laplace transform. In the second class, I solved some problems. Now I'm going to solve some more problems based on some different types of problems. The another problem is third one, 3s plus 2 divided by s square minus s minus 2. Now already I told whenever having a denominator in the form of quadratic, numerator having s, better I to go for complete the square method. Here what happened? S square is plus term, s term is 2ab term is minus. Therefore, what's the possibility? I go for a minus b whole square. But I'm not going to use complete the square method because s square minus s minus 2 is nothing but my s is a is s, a square is s square. Here which one is missing? 2 is missing. That's why if you want to require 2, what we are going to do? Multiply divided by 1 by 2 and then yes, my what about that b is what actually half. Add and subtract by half is what we get actually 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4. This is we get a fraction. Once you convert, see add and subtract by what? 1 by 4 minus 1 by 4, the remaining constant. You group these three, we get which one? S minus half whole square. This we get a fraction. It's not look nice. Better I go for partial fraction because it's possible to factorize this. You know how to factorize. Before going to apply inverse transform, I'm going to use this as a fraction. I'm going to convert this in terms of, instead of quadratic, I'm going to convert in the form of a product of two linear terms by using factorization method. The factors are s minus 1 and s minus 2. S minus 1 and s plus 1 into s minus 2. Just to multiply that, what we get? S square plus s minus 2s plus s minus 2s, what we get? Minus s plus into minus s minus. Therefore, what are the two factors here? S plus 1 into S minus 2. You know how to factorize. Once you multiply, we get this. Once you factorize, we get product of two linear form, then easy to go for partial fraction. Therefore, instead of this using complete the square method, I go for partial fraction. What my conclusion is, you just look into the fraction. Either you go for complete the square method, partial fraction. Based on the convenient, you proceed. At the end, we get same answer. Now, what we get actually? 3 by both a non-repeated linear factor, s plus 1, b by s minus 2. Take LCM. Once you take LCM, both the sides denominators are cancels. What's the remaining? 3s plus 2 must be equal to a into s minus 2. And then b into what actually? S plus 1. Now, I am taking it as my convenient is strong. I have to give different values of s. I have to find out a and b. Put s is equal to 2. Once you put s is 2, what happens? A is 0, but b is not equal to 0. I have to put s is 2 on both the sides. 3 into 2. What is 3 into 2 is 6. Plus 2 equals a is 0. B into what actually? 2, we get 3. That implies what we get actually 6 plus 2, what we get? 8. 8 equal to 3b, that implies what is my b? 8 by 3. Similarly, I have to calculate a value, therefore what we are going to put s is equal to minus 1. Once you put s is equal to minus 1, what happened? B value 0. Therefore 3 into minus 1 plus 2 equals a into minus 1 minus 2, what do we get? Minus 3. Now minus 3 plus 1, what we get actually? That implies minus 3 plus 2 is nothing but minus 1 equal to minus 3a. That implies what is my a? 1 by 3. Therefore, that implies L inverse 3s plus 2 divided by s square minus s minus 2 can be written as L inverse of what is my a? A value is 1 by 3 s divided by s plus 1. What is my b value? 8 by 3.
8 by 3 divided by s minus 2. From the linear property, this can be written as, I'll keep 1 by 3 outside because it's a constant. It reverse of 1 by s plus 1 and then 8 by 3 into L inverse of what? 1 by s minus 2. Fine. Yeah. After you apply the Laplace transform, both the terms in the standard form, we know that L inverse of 1 by s minus a is what actually? E power of a t. Therefore, L inverse of the given function 3s plus 2 divided by s square minus s minus 2 can be written as 1 by 3. Keep in mind, what is s plus 1 can be written as what actually? S minus of minus 1. Therefore, what is my a value? Minus t plus 8 by 3. What is my a value here? 2. E power of 2t. This is a way to find out inverse Laplace transform of given function. Now, you keep in mind, not necessary to go for partial fraction or not necessary to go for complete the square method. Observe carefully which method we get very conveniently, very easiest thing. Based on that, either you go for complete the square method or I could go for which one? Partial fraction method. Now I'm going to take another one more last problem. Fourth one is s plus 5 divided by what is that actually? S square minus 6s plus 13. Now I want to find out the inverse transform of this L inverse of s plus 5 divided by s square minus 6x plus 13. Here I am not going to do the factorization method. You can't factor. See, 13. You don't get the factor for this. We can't convert a square minus 6x plus 13 in the form of product of two linear factors. You try it. Now, what's the power thing I'm going to use? Complete the square method. And also here we don't have only s. We have anyway 6x, we get 2. Therefore, no issue for to use complete the square method. What's the function here? S square minus 6x plus 13. Please try to understand why I am not converting to the product of two linear terms. Because you can't factorize. The next is, a is my s, a square. I told beginning of the class of last previous classes, either you go for complete as a plus b whole square or a minus b. Here, a square is plus, 2ab is minus, if I go for only a minus b. A square minus 2ab, 3, 6 can be written as 3 into 2. Yes, now a is yes, 2a, the remaining is 3. Therefore, what you require? 9, 3 square at required. Therefore, 9, 13 can be written as 9 plus 4. Therefore, 9 plus 4. No need to make add and subtract binary. If you want to add and subtract, we get same thing. Add to subtract 9 from 13, we get 4. Now, group these three terms, what we get actually? S minus 3 whole square plus 4. Yes? I'm going to replace this. This is nothing but L inverse of S plus 4, 5 divided by S minus 3 whole square plus 4. 4 can also be written as 2 square. Now you recall one of the formula, numerator having S, therefore L inverse of S, or whatever that, minus b divided by s minus b whole square plus a square is nothing but e power of bt into sin at, right? This is in the form of, this is now in the form of this. How can you know that? I told you must be know Laplace, what happened for inverse. Then only easy to recognize, I go for which formula. Otherwise, even though I solve 10 or 20 problems, no use. Then, now I am trying to convert numerator also in the form of s minus b. What is my s minus b? S minus b. If I convert numerator also in the form of s minus b, what I am going to do here, add and subtract by 3 in the numerator. Minus 3 plus 3, what we get? 3 plus 5 is 8 divided by s minus 3 whole square plus 2 square. Now I'm going to split the term. This can be from the whatever the linear property, this can be written as s minus 3 divided by s minus 3 whole square plus 2 square plus 8 is a constant. I'll keep it outside. The limit of what actually 1 by s minus 3 whole square plus 2 square. You know simultaneously another formula, L inverse of 1 by s minus 3 whole square plus a square is nothing but 1 by a into e power of bt into sin at. This is cos at, sorry, this is one actually what actually cos at, sorry. Whenever having s, we get a cos. Whenever you don't have any sign for s function in the numerator, we get a sign. Yes? Now, both in the form, therefore, now we are going to apply first shifting property. By shifting property. Now, you already know that what is my shifting property? L inverse of capital F of s minus a is nothing but e power of a b into L inverse of what actually? Capital F of s. You go for this formula directly or you go for shifting property. Choice of you. By shifting property. Are you clear? Yeah. Why I insist to go for shifting property? Can't remember always this formula. Okay? No. Suppose after shifting property, instead of s minus what we get s by s square plus 2 square. Oh, you have a cos formula. Here we get 1 by s square plus 2 square. We have a sine formula. That's a very addition to know that. Instead of knowing entire the result for this, that's why I insist the student to apply inverse whatever shifting property. While applying shifting property, whatever shifting property says, e power of whatever that 3 t, L inverse of other than 3 is s by s square plus 2 square. Yeah, this is in the standard form. And also 8 into e power of my whatever that 3 t into L inverse of 1 by s square plus 2 square. You know the formula for this. E power of 3t. What is the formula for this? Cos 8t. What is a 2t? Here 2 is missing in the numerator. Therefore 1 by 2. Yes. E power of 3t is there. 8 into e power of 3t. Into 1 by 2. Sin 2t. Now I have to simplify. If you want to take a common factor, e power of 3t what's the remaining? Cos 2t plus 4, 2 1s are 2 4s are 4 sin 2t. This is a need to find out inverse transform, Laplace transform of the given function. Are you clear? Yes. Now you try to understand this. Now it looks like a very simple function. Now what I did, you can't do it factorized. I'm going to use complete the square method. I'm going to convert in the form of a minus b whole square. Now this split it into 2ab. The remaining is my b. Add and subtract by 3 square. Now what we get actually? 9 plus minus 9 plus 13 we get 4. Now group these three, we get a minus b whole square plus 4 can be written as 2 square. Now this is in the standard form. But I want to convert s also in the form of s minus 3, then I will go for shifting property. Therefore, what I did, add and subtract by 3, now we get plus 8. Now, once you split that, this is in the form of what? See, just observe that. You can't remember this formula. If you possible to remember, fine. Otherwise, now, once you take it 3, what happened? Just you think, s by a square plus 2 square. Yeah, you have a formula for cos. Suppose you take it 3, what we get? S square plus 2 square. Therefore, I go for which property? Shifting property. What is our shifting property? Say that L inverse of f of s minus a. What is my a? 3 power of 3t. L inverse of other than 3. Here also 8 into L inverse 3 power of 3t into L inverse of 1 by s square plus 2 square. These two are nothing but this is cos, this is sin. Now while writing sin are equal to, therefore I take 2 as a cross multiplication because it's a constant. 2 into sin of 2t. Sin of 2t. Now if you want to take common factor, otherwise leave it as itself. Definitely you are not going to lose any marks. simplify that. I think everyone is clear how to solve by using computer square method. Well, I come to my first problem today class here. Here, either you go for factorization method or you go for completing the square method. I explain, suppose you go for completing the square method, what you are facing a problem, we get a fraction value. What I am going to do, instead of that using completing the square method, I have to convert in the form of a minus b whole square, then it's possible I have to factorize it. This, what are the two factors are s plus 1 into s minus 2. This is very simple. We know the form of inverse formula also. Therefore, from the partial fraction, I have to convert into sum of two terms. And next, I have to find out a and b value. And also, this fraction is what? Proper fraction. Because highest degree of the numerator is 1, highest degree of the denominator is 2. Now, take LCM and simplify that. Give the different values of yes, we get a and b value. Once we get a and b, I have to replace it. This is a way to convert sum of two terms. But both the terms in the standard form, what is that? L inverse of 1 by s minus is e power kt. Just apply that, s plus 1 can be written as s minus of minus 1. In this case, a is minus 1, in this case, a is 2. Immediately we get. You compare both the problem. I tell you once again, while solving a problem for fraction, observe whether it's possible to factorize very easily in the form of linear fine. You can't factorize, you go for complete square method. Sometimes it's possible to factorize also. Suppose we get very comfortable manner for complete the square method, I'll go for complete the square method. Choice of you. I'll give based on my experience these are the tips to take it to solve the problem. Because in any textbook it's not given for this problem you go this method, this problem go. You only look like which method is convenient. Based on that, you go and use the method to proceed. Finally, we try to convert in the form of standard form. That's our main goal. Once you cover standard form, then we see to apply the inverse transfer. Okay, thank you very much for listening my talk. Yes, if you suppose you like my whatever video, please subscribe.